Good afternoon, class 10. In this video, we will study chapter 6C, that is a scattering of light and its various applications we will do. Now, the scattering of light, what does it mean? It's the simple meaning is basically the spreading of light in various directions. So, the scientist Rayleigh, he was the one who first studied the scattering of light. Now, what is scattering? See, when the light is incident on the air molecules or the dust particles in the atmosphere, they absorb this incident light energy, they absorb the light energy and then re-emits the light in various directions. That is, light is re-emitted, or basically light spreads in various directions. So this is the phenomena of scattering. Now, you have two cases. That is, first of all, if the size of the air molecules, if the size of the air molecules or the dust particles in the atmosphere, it's greater than the wavelength of the incident light, then they scatter all the wavelengths of white light, that means the different components of white light, in the same extent. That means the scattering is same. How much they will say, for example, how much red light will be scattered, how much violet light will be scattered, that all will be same. Okay, so the scattering is same for the different wavelengths of white light. But for the size of air molecules or the dust particles less than the wavelength of the incident light, in that case, we find that the scattering is not same for all the wavelengths of light. That means it's different for red, blue, violet, like this. So, there we get the relation between intensity of scattering I and wavelength of the incident light. So, the intensity of the scattering is directly proportional to the inverse, the reciprocal of fourth power of lambda. Or in other words, I can say, basically, simply, it is directly, it's inversely proportional to the wavelength, the fourth power of wavelength. So, if I say direct proportional, then it is directly proportional to the reciprocal of fourth power of lambda. Or in other words, I can say it is inversely proportional to the fourth power of lambda. That means more is the wavelength, less is the intensity of scattering. So, as we go from violet end to the red end of Wybjeer, wavelength increases. If wavelength increases, then intensity of scattering will decrease. That means red light is minimum scattered because it has a maximum wavelength. Violet light, it has got the minimum wavelength, so it will be scattered maximum. Now let's have a look at the various applications of the scattering of light. See, Earth, and this is a layer of atmosphere. Now, you have, say there an observer is placed on the Earth's surface. Now, at sunset or sunrise, see, the sun is at the maximum distance from the observer, isn't it? But throughout the day, it is not at the maximum distance. This is throughout the day. This is sun at noon and this is also throughout the day. For the other positions, it's not the maximum distance, right, from the observer. Then, when the sun is at the maximum distance at during the sunrise or sunset, what will happen then? At that time, now, which color of light is scattered the most? Violet light or blue light, basically as we go up from violet end to red end, scattering intensity decreases. So red color of light is scattered the least. That means while traveling the long distance, the other colors of light will have lost its incident light energy, right? Because already it is scattered. So that means the incident, the light, visible light energy from the for the observer, it's not prominent for the rest of the colors of light, but we can see the red color because it is scattered the least, and since it is traveling through a long distance, the color which will scatter the least will actually retain the incident light energy. Basically, that means it will be visible to us prominently. Now, what about for the case when the sun is at the top of our head? That means at noon, we find the white color of sky. Why? See the distance. Now, we already know that perpendicular distance is always the shortest distance between any two points. Now, can you find the perpendicular distance when the sun is at noon? So that means the light has to travel the minimum distance. So that is why the scattering of the different colors of light is not affecting much, because it's a very short distance the light has to travel. So even if red light is scattered the least and violet is scattered the most, even if that is the case, but what will happen? Since it's a very short distance the light, white light has to cover, so the different components, irrespective of this being scattered in different proportions, what will happen? Ultimately we will be able to see the white composite color of sky, because due to the short distance, its scattering is not that much. Because obviously you can see, if it has to travel a longer distance, it will be scattered more. Shorter distance, it won't be scattered that much, right? So that means we are seeing the white color of the sky. Now throughout the day, if we actually, you can just imagine the case that if we look at the sun, so basically the direct light from the sun we are getting is a red light because it's the least scattered. But what about the entire sky? We get the light from the entire sky from different directions. Which color? Blue color, because it is scattered in all possible directions. It's scattered in all possible directions. So that is why we get to see the bluish violet. It's not violet actually, it's bluish color we see for the sky. Now come to this point, the white color of clouds. See, the clouds are always not, obviously the distance between the clouds and earth surface is not the same as the distance between the sun and the earth surface. So clouds are very much nearer to the earth surface. Now also the molecules of the clouds, see, they contain clusters or aggregates of water molecules and dust particles. Clouds are made up of that. So ultimately the size of the molecules greater than the wavelength of the incident light, which falls under which category? See, we have already discussed this. Size of air molecules, if greater than the wavelength of the incident light, scattering of the light of all wavelengths of white light is same. So ultimately what will we see? We will finally see the white composite color of the clouds, because since all the colors of white light are basically scattered to the same extent, so finally we get to see the white color. Now next is, see, the danger signal. Why is it made red? Say for example, if it was made of any other color apart from red, say blue or any other color of vibgium, that would have been scattered a lot, but red scatters the least. Now, see, an observer is at a far distance from the danger signal. Which one will be able to see? Red or the blue or any other color. Obviously red, because it has actually scattering the least, so it is basically able to penetrate longer distances without being much scattered. Whereas blue or any other color will be scattered so much that ultimately very weak light energy will be perceived by the observer. So red one is preferred as a danger signal.